Join us. It is day five. We're here at the Riverwalk Park in Murphy, North Carolina. This is Dixie's first time out. We're working on leash manners. The Riverwalk Park, I'm going to do sort of a test with Dixie. This is a very low distraction environment. Previously to coming here, we stopped in downtown Murphy for moderate high distraction evaluation. That'll be coming up. So let's go ahead and get started with our follow command. Dixie, follow. And let's progress over to our heel command. Usually once a dog learns heel, the follow command and the heel command sort of look identical. The follow command, they're both on 4-foot leashes. Ruby, Dixie, follow. Heel. adjusted over time in terms of her becoming desensitized to the noises. Ruby, come. Ruby, sit. Okay, so I've got 2 4-foot leashes. Normally I've been using 6-foot leashes, but if I'm going to work with 2 dogs, having that extra 2 feet when you walk 2 dogs is a lot to handle from a leash management standpoint. So I'm going to go ahead and attach these 4-foot leashes, and this is the first time, and we're going to see how this goes. Always attach the leashes to the flat collars, not the e-collars. Girls follow. So we're going to start with the follow and then we'll progress into the heel. Girls follow. Ruby, Dixie, follow. And with the follow command, they can either sit or stand. It doesn't matter when I stop, just so their feet stop moving too. Follow. And turn. Again, we're doing the follow, so it's okay that Dixie stands. Okay, so I'm going to change out to a Y connector and just use 1 leash. And I would choose a 6-foot leash if you're going to use a Y connector, which is going to attach to both dogs' collars. And let me show you how that works. Okay. You will probably hear me say, girls follow. I have 2 girl dogs, so when I'm working both of my dogs, I just refer to them as girls. You can try with Finn and Dixie at some point to think of a name that you can call both of them, since you have a boy and a girl, and just try it out as time goes on and see if that works for you. Okay, so I've got a 6-foot leash and this Y connector here, and I'm going to go ahead and take off the 4-foot leashes and change this out to this connector piece. Wait. And again, this is the first time. I haven't done any previous practice with Dixie and Ruby using this. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and toss these leashes. Again, this is for Dixie's benefit of desensitizing her just to objects. Okay, that looked really good that time. Okay, so I'm just going to ask them to follow. Dixie, Ruby, follow. Okay. doing really well. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and change out of the follow command to the heel command. Both Ruby and Dixie heel on the left side. Ruby has a really tight heel next to my leg. I have Dixie on the inside connector of this Y. So maybe at some point I'll change her over to the outside connector because I already know Ruby's going to come in really close to my left leg. But let's see how this goes. Ruby, Dixie heel. Ruby, Dixie heel. Ruby, Dixie heel.
Good.
Ruby, Dixie heel. Sit. That's pretty good. They're doing really well. Ruby, Dixie heel. Sit. Okay, and you can see Dixie's on the inside and seems to be working out really well. Okay, we're going to go ahead and do a few more heels with some stops. Again, looking for that heel position, dog's shoulder even with my left leg. No tension on the leash. They should be turning and not coming out of the defined heel. Ruby, Dixie heel. Ruby, Dixie heel. Ruby, Dixie heel. Good girls. Oh, what good girls. Ruby, Dixie heel. That's it. Good job. Go ahead and disconnect their leash and set them into their release command. Ruby, Dixie, break. And again, I do let my poodle jump on me. Girls play. Oh, Dixie.
Good girl.
See if they're going to warm up to each other and see if Dixie's going to play a little bit. Dixie, break. Dixie, break. Ruby, play. Dixie, wait. Ruby, play. Ruby, sit. Dixie, follow. Dixie, place. Dixie, place. time. Wait. Dixie, come. Ruby, come. Wait. Dixie, come. Ruby, come. Wait. Dixie, come. Ruby, come. Dixie, please. Ruby, please. Come. Ruby, come. Ruby, sit. Good. Dixie, Ruby, follow.
Ruby, follow.
Dixie, follow.
Ruby, follow.
Dixie, follow.
Ruby, follow.
Dixie, follow. Ruby, follow. Okay, they're learning their name. We're pretending Ruby's Finn.
Dixie, follow.
Ruby, follow.
Wait.
Dixie, follow. Good. Very good.
Dixie, follow.
Dixie, follow. Follow. Hey, Dixie, Ruby, sit. Ruby, Dixie, follow.
Dixie, follow.
Ruby, Dixie, sit. Good. Wait. Dixie, come. Good. Dixie, place. Dixie, place. Good. Ruby, place. Dixie, Ruby, freak.
Good girl. Good girl.
We're gonna play. Thank you. Okay, so she heard the noise of a car on the gravel road over behind the fence line. You can see how she was more focused on that than playing with Ruby. Ruby's trying very hard to get her to play. Ruby, go play. Go play. Play. Dix is not interested in playing, or rather, it's probably not interested is not the right word. It really boils back down to that birth to 4 month old period where they're imprinted and socialized. She's also got some variables going on. Being here in a new environment, we are on day 7. She has tried to play with Ruby yesterday when we ran some training exercises and then went release command.